Hey there, people. Welcome to What's Up, a bilingual strategy done by the Education Secretariat for the Culture of Antioquia. Stay with us, because this is about to start. Moving patients from one city to another, taking care of their lives, and providing the highest quality medical service. That's the mission of the group of people we'll see today.
Este equipo humano compartió con nosotros una jornada de trabajo en la que fuimos testigos de la labor que realizan dentro de sus aeronaves, mientras atienden las más diversas contingencias que se presentan en el área de la salud.
Want to know more? Let's check it out.
Osarpa is a company that has 29 years of experience in charter, in air charter. And now, 9 years ago, we started with the program of air ambulance. Osarpa transfer many patients from hospitals from level one that are not very specialized and they don't have very well equipment to hospitals in Medellin, Bogota for a better treatment.
One day here of work is, it starts when we get a call. They call us, we come here. The specialist in emergency medicine, the professional nurse, therapist of the airway. We get all the information we can get from the patient, so we prepare all our equipment. They pick us up in the airport. There's an ambulance that takes us to the local hospital. Then there we actually evaluate the patient. We prepare him to get on the plane, we stable him, we work on ground, and when he's stable, when the situation is secure, then we transfer him in the plane. Then we take them to, like we travel to Medellin or to Bogota, where there's another ambulance waiting for us, and that ambulance take him to the better, much high level complexity hospital. To be a doctor here is really different from our works in our hospitals, because here, besides the complexity of the patients, we have also the concern of the altitude and the weather and the noise of the plane and the movements. Here we are in the plane, in the air ambulance. I'm gonna show you a little bit around of the equipment we have. Here, for example, we have our bags. There's a bag, for example, this one, respiratory bag, drugs, pediatric and neonatal equipment, and all the things we need for little surgeries and little procedures. Here we have the infusion pumps, the monitor, the defibrillator, and the ventilator. This is the stretcher where we lay the patient on. And we have the oxygen supply and all the electrical and energy supplies go over here. Here we have lots of experience and lots of interesting experience. For example, this story is from a patient, an indigenous from Leticia, that he was really sick. If we wouldn't take him out, he would have died. So when we got there to pick him up, it was the first time he saw a plane. It was the first time he got on a plane. He didn't have shoes, he didn't have clothes, he didn't speak our language, he didn't speak Spanish, he had a dialect, so it was very difficult to communicate with him. And we transported him to Bogota, where he was managed, well managed, and he did well and recovered from his sickness, and then we take him back to his village in the forest.
Roger Arias. I'm a pilot, just in 32 in this company, SARPA. All the missions are different, We have to take patients from many cities in Colombia. We have to be ready for accomplish some different missions to take patients from the cities far away. Our mission is to stay there for 1 hour, 2 hours. Meanwhile, the doctors take care of the patient. They prepare the patients. It's a very amazing work.
We pick up patients from everywhere, and we go to Curaçao, Trinidad and Tobago, we go to Aruba. They don't speak Spanish. So, for example, to communicate with them, it has to be in English. And sometimes it has to be in French. But normally, everyone speaks English, so that makes our work easier.